Why is cache preloading important for improving the performance of your site? Preloading ensures your visitors get the speedier cached versions of your site right away. WPRocket automatically takes care of this, and in this video, we'll see how. When you activate WPRocket for the first time, the plugin begins generating cached versions of your content right away. When you activate the sitemap-based cache preloading option, sitemaps generated by popular SEO plugins will be automatically detected and preloaded. You can also specify your own sitemaps by entering their URLs in the sitemaps for preloading text field. These sitemaps will be preloaded after the homepage URLs with no duplication whenever you change WPRocket settings and whenever you click the preload link from the admin toolbar or on the WPRocket dashboard. If you have enabled the separate cache files for mobile devices option, mobile cache files will also be preloaded in addition to desktop cache files. If you think preloading isn't working on your site, first check to see whether or not cache files are being generated after you click the preload button. To do so, you can use either the file manager in your cPanel or an FTP client. Then navigate to the wp-rocket folder, which is inside the cache folder within your wp-content directory. Within the WPRocket folder, you should see a subfolder named after your domain. Inside that folder, you'll find any cache files that have been created. Now select the preload cache link from the WPRocket admin toolbar. Wait a few moments, then refresh the cache folder in your file manager. You should see new files added. You can check the date to see when they were created. To make sure preloading works as expected, check whether or not wpcron can run on your WordPress site using the wpcron status checker plugin. After activating the plugin, visit your dashboard and look for the wpcron status checker widget. You can also check your site health status from your WordPress dashboard to check that scheduled events haven't failed and loopback requests are indeed working. You should also make sure that your homepage and sitemap URLs are publicly reachable, that your sitemap URL is entered correctly on the preload tab, and that your security measures are not blocking access to your site. Now, if you get a curl error 28 notice, this usually indicates a slow server response time. If that happens, you should get in touch with your hosting provider and ask how to improve your service performance. In any other case, feel free to contact our amazing support team through our website. They'll be happy to help you out. And thanks for watching.